You're tuned to Radio Kidnappers, the voice of Hawke's Bay. This is the wonderful world of Wardini Books, and our pleasure, as always, to have in the studio Lou from Wardini Books in Havelock North. Hey, going, Lou?
I'm great, Ken. How are you?
Oh, good. We're right in the middle of winter, and but we can see the light at the end of the tunnel.
Yeah, it doesn't last long in Hawke's Bay, does it?
Summer's just around the corner, isn't it? Mm. What do you do to warm up? What's your favourite get-home winter meal?
Oh, God, I'm rubbish at food. I don't know. I just bought a packet of soup. It's got ginger in it. That's warming.
That's exciting. I thought you might have a casserole with dumplings and yum, dark gravy and...
No, I don't eat meat, so
That sort of puts that out of the contention, yeah. Doesn't it?
We did have a jacket potatoes the other night. That was very good.
Oh, yeah, that would be nice. You could maybe try a tofu burger. Apparently they're quite good too.
Yeah.
Let's get down to business. The New Neighbours, what's that all about?
This is a picture book by Sarah McIntyre.
Yeah.
And as you can see on the back, there's a beautiful block of flats there in Pickle Rye.
Yeah.
And we've got the bunnies on the top floor. We've got a sheep. We've got a family of piggies. We've got polar bears and we've got yaks. And we've got bunnies. The bunnies are quite mad, hopping around all over the place.
I love it.
But it starts off, there's going to be new residents at Pickle Rye. High on the roof above the city, Mr. Pigeon had the latest news. "You've got rats in your flats," he burbled with glee. "They've moved in today on the ground floor." Can you see where this is going?
Yes, I can see it, yeah.
Yeah, so then there's all like, "Oh, rats. We're not quite sure about rats." And the rabbits are bouncing around and getting all excited about it. So they go down to tell their big sister, Lettuce. "We've got rats in our flats." They're like, "Oh, I've never lived with rats before." And it kind of escalates from there. So they all get a little bit worried and they go down and talk to Vern, who's a rather large sheep. "Do you want to come and say hi to the rats, Vern?" He's like, "Oh, I don't think they're very tidy neighbours. They're not very clean." And it just gets worse and worse and worse, all this judgment gorgeous family of rats that they've never even met. So they're accused before they've even been seen of being messy and smelly, and they're bad news. And so the whole bunch of people/animals in the flat go down and, "Oh, rats, big, dirty, smelly, thieving, dangerous rats have moved in downstairs and they're going to make the whole building collapse and bury us alive in rat poo." And it's just got, it's kind of like listening to one of Donald Trump's tweets or something.
Yes, I was going
to
say, so it's a reflection of society, isn't it?
And how it all just goes completely bonkers without any evidence at all. So eventually they go down and they're just about to, it's Lettuce, the little rabbit, is knocked on the door of the rat flat. And the door opens and a small, tidy, friendly-looking rat smiled up at them and invites them in for homemade cake. And they're very tidy and they're very clean and very lovely. But even the rats are quite aware that they might not have the best reputation, which is a little bit sad.
Indeed.
But the residents do feel suitably chastened.
Good on them. Another tippy topic book available from...
Yes, Ken.
I'm never going to forget that. You know that.
No, I know.
And our next book, in fact, we've got two books. One is called The Agency and one is called The Second Grave. That sounds quite a good one, doesn't it?
If you like really good thrillers, then Ian Austin is a Kiwi author. He's originally from the UK. And the reason he's so good at writing thrillers is because he was a copper. Like me.
Oh, right, yes.
But he did all sorts of sneaky, beaky, undercover, dangerous stuff. So... his writing reflects that, you know, and he was in danger quite a bit and got into some scrapes. And his main character, Dan Calder, is an ex-cop. He's moved out of the job. He's moved from England to New Zealand, but he seems to still manage to get himself embroiled in things. So in book one, he's an ex-Brit and an ex-policeman looking for a fresh start in a new country, but he's quite depressed and traumatised, really, I think, by his career in the police. But then there's this... an agency in the UK, and there's a connection to New Zealand, and the agency promises to give you a good death. So it's like a euthanasia agency.
Oh, right, sort of like Soylent Green.
Yeah.
Remember that movie?
Yeah, creepy.
Yeah.
What this woman does in the agency is she promises you it'll be beautiful and you can be a mermaid, go back into the sea and you can do what you like, but really she's just murdering people and taking all their money.
Right.
And pretending to be what she isn't. So in that first book, Dan Calder has to, he becomes involved in that. And in the second one, he's gone back to England for a bit and he's going to help his best friend and ex-partner, Nick, because Nick's daughter's been arrested in connection with the death of a prostitute in Nottingham, which is where I'm from.
Yes, and I bet you could tell a few stories as a policewoman yourself.
Yeah, policing in Nottingham. There were some quite interesting incidents.
Some good stuff, though. Some good stuff to talk about. as a police person?
Oh, yeah. I mean, most of my stories are gruesome and unpleasant, really.
Ooh, they're the best ones.
Yeah, they are, really.
Anyway, just going back to those two books, you've got a gig coming up.
We do. So Ian is going to be at Hastings Library at 6:30 on Monday the 9th of July, mm-hmm. so this coming Monday. And he talks a lot about his time in the police. So if you've got an interest in thriller writing or in what cops do, then come along.
Yeah, what time is it?
6:30.
You're listening to Radio Kidnappers, the voice of Hawke's Bay. This is the wonderful world of Wardini Books. Lou is here from Wardini Books in Havelock North. Got another branch in Napier.
We do.
Now, the next book is Boy Swallows Universe. I love it.
I'm a massive fan of this book. Mm. You know, when you ask me how many out of 10, this would be like 100 out of 10.
Well, it really.
But when I first start to tell you what it's all about, you're like, oh, God, not another one of these depressing books that she reads.
You like those ones,
I do a little. But this one is not really what you think. So it's set in Australia. And it's just outside of Brisbane. And there's a boy called Eli, and he's about 12, and his brother August is about a year older. August is mute. He hasn't spoken since the car accident he was in with the father and Eli when he was quite small, 4, I think. And so he doesn't speak, but he manages to communicate, and he draws words in the air, and he's got quite mystical properties. He seems to be able to see what's coming sometimes. The father is long gone. They live with mum and Francis and stepfather Lyle, who are both ex-heroin addicts.
I'm depressed already.
I know. And they're dealers as well. Yeah, so this is the environment these kids have been brought up in. And their babysitter is a convicted murderer called Slim.
Of course.
So it all sounds really depressing, but it actually starts with this gorgeous little scene where Slim's teaching Eli to drive. And there's such love and respect between these people. And Lyle, the stepfather, although he is a heroin dealer, a drug dealer, is just... he's a father to those boys, and the mum loves them to bits. They've just got themselves into... they just live in a really weird situation. So all sorts of stuff happens. Lyle gets on the wrong side of somebody, and mum goes to prison. And then it's all about how is Eli going to keep his family together? And the things that August is writing in the air, the mystical stuff, how's that going to tie in? And it was just fantastic.
Yeah, so it's a 10.
Oh, yeah, more than a 10. It was really readable, and it's funny because Eli's got such... he's quite a bonkers little personality, really, whereas August is this calm, mystical one. Eli is the rabbit family from bouncing around.
Yeah. Sounds like it might have a happy ending.
Oh, it was great. It's got a really good ending.
And the last book we're going to look at today is 100% Business.
Yes, this is another exciting thing for Hawke's Bay because Ryan Jennings, the author of this, 100% Business, 9 Kiwi Success Navigators. So if you're interested in business in any way, what Ryan Jennings did, Hawke's Bay boy, now living in Wellington, he took his business background from being born into a family that owned business and then doing a business degree and working for corporates. He was interested in what up-and-coming startups are doing and how you do things differently to the corporates. So his 9 success navigators are selling your business, the psychology of success. I think selling your business as in like... getting it out there in the world. Results by learning, starting your business, crush-worthy branding, performance marketing, create and capture value, specialist perspectives, celebrating generational businesses. And there's a lot of him in this book, and there's a tiny bit of me.
Yeah,
because
indeed.
I'm in it. Because he did something called 100 CEOs. Gareth always takes the mickey out of me. Oh, you're a CEO, are you? Very posh. But he interviewed 100 people who were doing interesting things, things that he found interesting in business. And there's a bit of all of us in this book.
You say interesting things. I would say successful things.
Yeah.
You've done really well, haven't you?
Or, you know, indicators for success. You know, people striving to do the best that they can with what they're trying to do. Yeah.
You get a 10 for that, Lou.
Thanks, mate. So Ryan's actually going to come and sign copies of this book.
Yep.
So he'll be in Hawke's Bay again on Saturday the 14th of July. He'll be in our Havelock North shop at 11 a.m. and our Napier shop at 1 p.m.
Good on you, Lou. As was a pleasure. Just remind our listeners, want to come and see you in Havelock North. What's the street?
Tomato Road.
And in Napier?
Hastings Street.
As always, our pleasure. You look after yourself. We'll talk to same time, same place next week.
Thanks, Ken.